Hey, how's it going, guys? I'm Jose Daniel, and welcome back to another video. I hope you're having a great time, a great day, and enjoying this series of how to build your video editing PC. Today, we're going to talk about the memory RAM. In this case, I have the Corsair DDR4, 32GB, and 3000MHz. So when I was looking for a memory RAM, I just think is, okay, we choose the type, in this case, DDR4, I will choose the capacity, 32GB, and then I will choose the speed, 3000MHz. But when I was looking and see the specification in the motherboard, I was noticing that it said that non-ECC, ECC memory RAMs, unbuffer, buffer, latency, voltage, and other things. So what that means, it made me a little bit confused. And start looking some information about it to understand a little bit more what that means. So today I'm going to explain you a little bit more, and then you can understand more and choose the right memory RAM for you. First, we need to know what the memory RAM does, and we understand for memory RAM as memory random access, and this is the memory storage, the data and the information for the program we are using at the moment, and quick communication for the CPU. So first we need to know which type of memory RAM we are going to use in our system. You can find that in the motherboard specification. In this case, we have the DDR4, and this is able for high speed and efficiency. The next thing we can find the capacity of the memory RAM. We can find from 2GB of RAM up to 32GB. These are the most common in these days. The other thing is the speed of the memory RAM is the megahertz. You can find them in the motherboard specification and the CPU to choose the right one and to be which one is compatible for it. So the next thing we can find is the ECC and non-ECC memory RAMs. So what this means, normally the memory RAMs comes with 8 chips, and these chips will receive and deliver the information. But the ECC memory RAMs, we can understand the ECC as error correction code. These memory RAMs are more expensive, and they have 9 chips instead of 8. And this extra chip is going to look for any missing code or any error in the system. So this means it's a little bit slower as the non-ECC, because the extra chip have to look for the information forward and backward to look for errors and correct them. So these memory RAMs, you are going to find them when you need a really precise information as banking or business areas, and you don't want to miss any zero in your bank account, isn't it? So the other thing you will find handy and helpful this type of memory RAMs is when you have a really high production, you are editing a really big project as a movie, and you will spend a lot of time editing the video, and then you are going to spend like 1 or 2 days or too much time rendering the video, as well as you have many effects, many transitions, or is a large content, a large movie. So in this case, you will need a ECC memory RAM. Let's say you are going to render the video for 1 or 2 days, and maybe in the first day or half of day rendering the video, you have, I don't know, let's say 40% of it, and then an error comes, the program crash, and you have to restart again the render. So in this case, it's really good to have an ECC memory RAM, as they will find any errors and correct them, and all the information is going to be precise. So the next thing we can find, the buffer and unbuffer memory RAMs. So buffer has an extra hardware between the CPU and the memory RAM, and this will store the information before it sends to the CPU. We can find these systems when you have a lot of memory RAMs as a large servers. So, but normally in our computers or laptops, we have an unbuffered memory RAMs. The last thing we can find is the voltage of the memory RAMs, the pins. In this case, we have 288 pins. Those are those ones here on the bottom of the memory RAM, and these are for the connection. And the last thing is the latency of the memory RAM. This is the timing, communication, and the time it takes to look for and find the information and data. And those are the specifications for the memory RAMs. I hope you like this video, as well as you understand a little bit more the specification for the memory RAMs and choose the right one for your necessities. So hit the like button, leave your comment below, and let me know if you have any question, if you want to know a little bit more of these topics. Subscribe if you're not to don't miss further videos, and see you guys in the next video. The other thing we can find is the speed of the memory RAM. It comes from 2666 up to 4600 something. No me acuerdo cuánto era.